Hey, this is Timothy Francis McTague from Underoath, and this is the first ever video journal entry for the recording of our new compact disc out on Solid State Records. We're gonna go check out Glow in the Dark. Here's where we're gonna be recording our drums and keyboards.
It's time to freaking make a record.
Oh God! Everything, everything!
Couple amps, couple keyboards, hardwood floors. Go check out the old control room. Monitors, computer, little glass so you can see what's going on. Microphone. If this record were to come out and go quadruple platinum, and you were in a position where you could have anything on the rider that you would like, what would it be?
Well, I thought long and hard about this question. I've come up with a pretty extensive rider that I'm going to type out and give to Suzanne in the near future.
Consisting of?
Well, my room, my own private dressing room, would be no less than 1,000 square feet with its own private bathroom. And in the bathroom will be located a jacuzzi tub kept at 106 degrees at all times for me to use however I would like.
Hey! There's the man of the hour.
One night we were just sitting there, we were trying to wrap our heads around who we would feel comfortable producing the record. And Matt Goldman from Atlanta, a guy who we've recorded with plenty of times doing pre-production and just a lot of different things, helped us write some of the programming for the last record. We just felt really comfortable with him.
How do you feel right now?
I mean, I feel pretty full.
Gino Mir?
That's what I like to hear.
He's pretty much like a feel-good vibe. Like when we work with him, things are just awesome and totally fun. And it's not like you're, you know, stressed out or working on something, you know, and freaking out about it. You're just like, it's all good times.
Matt can get really great drum sounds.
I'm a fan of not having a snare sound exactly the same through the whole record.
No, we'll change the next song.
Yeah. He's pretty much just a dude, man. He has his own facial hair, like his own name brand facial hair, the Goldman. Right there alone just pretty much says it all.
Day one, party!
Adam D is in the house.
Yeah. House? Me? Here?
The idea of Adam came up, and we just got off tour with Killswitch on the Taste of Chaos tour that year, and there's just a lot of different things going on where we're just like, man, that dude's legit.
I got some squeals and some dive bombs just for you guys. All reserved. It's gonna be sweet.
Man, if we could have just Matt Goldman and Adam collaborate on the record, it would just be awesome. It would sound good. It would have a good vibe. It would just, artistically, we felt like it would be there, and I got on the phone with Adam and just pretty much asked him and asked Matt that next day, and within a week or two, everything kind of worked out.
We were supposed to start drums today, but we decided to change course and demo out the entire record in one day, live, just so everyone can kind of show everyone their parts and get on the same page. So that's what we're getting ready to do right now.
I think that writing for this record was different because when we were writing for the last record, we didn't have a whole lot of time, and this time we had a lot more time to write, and it was pretty awesome.
This is where most of the Underoath stuff is written. Speaker right there and right there. They make sound. There's a laptop and just a couple things. It's a hard drive and a keyboard.
and yeah, pretty much just demo things out and come up with ideas, put them down, show the dudes, and vice versa. If it wasn't for modern technology, we wouldn't have been able to write this record, because pretty much been on the road all year, setting up two kits, silver IOT kit for the actual record, and that kit right there for demoing and just riffing out ideas so we don't beat up the heads on the big kit.
Have any special people at home? I think the people at home would like to know.
Would like to know what?
If you have a girlfriend, duh.
Do I have a girlfriend? At this point, I don't.
Situation where you know, we're in this poppy produced fake substanceless music scene where every band sounds the same, and we're trying to do something and keep the same mindset that we had when we were recording They're Only Chasing Safety, and that's to just keep pushing the limits, to put something in kids' hands that is unexpected, that's going to make them look outside, you know, their genre specific pop screamo CD collection. And so that's why we're doing things the way we are now. And when we were picking producers, we felt like we really needed somebody who got that, who understood and saw the vision for that. We just spent the last week recording. It's just a really good vibe. Trying different things, we were tweaking kits and had, you know, different drums set up in different parts of the room to get different effects, and we were just really trying a lot of different things, and that's something that we felt like we really needed to make sure was available to us, that creative outlet. All the songs have come together really, really good.
Oh, word!
I think I ungrouped your drums.
Oh no.
Now my dressing room will be themed. There will be multiple themes for different days. Whatever day I feel like having the theme be, it will be so said theme. One theme would be toy birthday party day. The room will be decked out in every Lego erector set, friggin' unbelievable Toys R Us, everything.
Erector set.
Dude, erector sets are bad as crap. And it'll be everything, and then right before I'm about to go to stage, like 1 hour, 10 people dressed up in full clown uniforms will come into the room with a birthday cake and sing me happy birthday to build my spirits before I play.
So we're here at Zing Studios in Westfield, Massachusetts. We're about to record some guitars for the old record, and yeah. Let's go check it out.
Yep, there it is. Ain't she a beaut? Four pretty sweet amps right there. Too hot to touch.
What's that? Oh, it's Chris's neck!
Oh!
2 days of growth. Here, come into the light.
I gotta get in the light.
Oh, no. Hold on, I gotta focus. Oh, yeah.
2 days?
It's not 2 days, is it?
Yeah, I shaved 2 days ago.
Oh.
I can grow it fast, but then I can't grow
Here,
it
Here, check
thick.
Mine.
Ponder. Ponder all that. Hmm.
How about the neck beard?
Right, you need more light. There you go. And look at that sucker.
Grant on this week's video update. Look at his Lego hair.
Tim's a little mad at me. I don't know if you can tell, my beard kind of took over his.
It's hair that came off of another Lego piece and clipped onto him. He can interchange it with medieval knights, space helmets. He can do anything. I think that's the title he's going for now. He's the Lego hair champion of Underoath.
Dude, let's see how much this dude's showcase is. Hold on. This young man bid $70,000 on a trip and a car. $29,000 difference of what is that? Freaking $40,000. Oh my god.
Oh no.
How does it feel also having Lego hair yourself?
Having Lego hair? Dude. Having Lego hair is great. There's nothing wrong with it.
Okay.
I mean, let's be honest. No, I actually have a date with my
girlfriend. Right now, we're in the middle of getting guitar sounds, bass sounds, etc. in here.
We didn't expect their only chasing safety to do close to what it did, and with that, we found a lot more pressure, a lot more eyes watching, expecting something from us, a lot of different people trying to get their hands on what we're doing, because we're not just a band that creates music anymore. We're a business venture, we're a risk, we're a possible high profit gain, pretty much just a business to a lot of people now.
If you were a flavor of Jell-O pudding snacks, one that may not exist or does exist in the Jell-O pudding snack line, what flavor would best describe you? Would it be salmon?
Asparagus?
Lobster?
Definitely not cream of shrimp. Definitely not. Tapioca. I'm white. I've got lots of little. I'm warm and squishy on the inside. I'm globule like.
Dude, one out of four ain't bad.
What was that garbage?
It wasn't garbage, no. But it kind of had an essence of garbage. Kind of like after you take out the trash. Odor lingers.
What's your favorite part during the week, especially Wednesday nights?
Oh gosh! Oh, that was the stupidest question.
I like to watch Lost with my friend Grant.
What a setup!
As you see, it's about a quarter after seven. Tim's in there tracking guitar. We're killing time in various ways. We're gonna go see what Grant's doing. It is a road case. with a built-in TV just for Halo. Wireless router.
Sport that headset. There you go.
Check one, so. Check one, so. Yes, it's still warm. He's been here.
He was once here.
We'll continue tracking the beast. Hidden track.
Not a big deal. It's just kind of what I do on an everyday basis. So, what happened, Steve?
Me and Adam were outside talking, and, pooped himself.
Dude, is it bad in there?
It looks like a stab wound.
So Adam just crapped his pants, in between guitar tracks and vocal tracks. Adam, you made some poopies in your pants. Adam,
disaster averted.
What happened?
I just felt the warm brown just seep and line the crack of my cookies.
We all do it on the...
Of mixing with Chris Lord Alge. Are you the Lord of the board?
You know I am.
We're just super psyched on the record. Man, yeah, it's just paid off. This is the last day of our mixing at Resonate Studios in Burbank, California, and we got a little going away present, a little Underoath cake. Chris!
Why gotta make fun of me, dude?
If you want to know what we're about, that's what we're about.
Cakes.
Right there.
Cake.
How do you feel about this release now that you've heard it in its fruition, Lord Alge?
Awesome.
You know, every song that we have is just on point.
It's done in the studio.
Not quite
freaking
done.
Out, man, I gotta get out. I'm freaking out. We've been in the studio for 6 days. Straight.
This is like the prologue.
This is it.
This is the exit hymn.
Every record we've ever recorded, we've always had that one song or those two or three songs that we wish were never there. And oh, those are the mistakes and the black sheep and the sore thumb of the record. And this record, I feel, has 10, 11 songs that are all there for a reason, that all play a part in making this record a cohesive unit.
I feel really good about the songs. I feel a lot more confident, I think, in these songs than I do anything else that we've ever done. I don't know how people are going to take them. I think that they're definitely the smartest songs that we've ever written. I think that a lot more thought went into them, a lot more time went into them, and I just enjoy them as a whole more than anything we've ever done, and I hope people like them.
Today's your birthday?
Yeah. No way. Oh, we have to sing happy birthday.
Okay, it's not really. But it is my birthday the day the record comes out, so that's kind of cool.
Okay.
Well, let's sing happy birthday to you now. Because it's all about the record.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear. Define the great line. Happy birthday to you! Go, Chris!
We all gotta blow it out! Everybody blow it out!
Yay!
Uno! Chris!
Dos!
Uno! Dos! Chris!
Yeah! Yeah.